Okay, well, guys, who knows what holidays coming up? Who knows what this is?
American
flag. Oh my goodness. Do you know what it stands for? Do y'all know what it stands for?
America.
Okay. But what does it mean when people fly it? What does it mean?
Don't say that.
It mean what? What does it mean? We're proud of it, right? It means freedom. Our flag means freedom, right? It says on here, oops, I'm sorry. I'm trying to do this like you guys who do the computer, but it's the first time I've done this like on here. Okay, this week we'll celebrate the 4th of July. That is our country's birthday. This morning, I have a flag. The flag of the United States, as you know, our flag is red, white, and what?
Blue.
Have you ever stopped to think about what these colors mean? Have you ever thought about it, other than it's red, white, and blue?
I know that the red means the blood.
Okay, is it? Okay, red stands for courage. Men and women have had the courage to stand up and fight for our country. They have defended our country against enemies, and many have died in the service of our country, right? Mm-hmm. White stands for purity. Purity means to do what is right. We hope and pray that our country will always stand for what is right, right? In these troubled times, it's hard. Blue, what, Charlie? Blue stands for justice. When we pledge allegiance to the flag, we end with the words, with liberty and justice for all. That means that in our country, everyone, no matter what religion, what color, where they came from, or what, should be treated fairly and with respect, right? The colors, red, white, and blue, remind me of our country. But those colors also remind us of what? You said it a while ago.
With people who died for
us. Of Jesus. Right? The blood of Jesus, right? Okay, the blood of Jesus that was shed as he died on the cross for us. That's very important because the Bible says without the shedding of blood, there is no forgiveness. And that's in Hebrews 9:22. White reminds me that when I give my heart to Jesus, he washes me and I become white as snow. And that's in Isaiah. The Bible says you were washed, you were sanctified, and you were justified in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. 1 Corinthians 6:10. Blue reminds me of God's faithfulness. The Bible tells us that if we confess our sins, he is faithful and just will forgive us for our sins and make us clean. God is faithful to keep his promises. Red, white, and blue. Yes, I am reminded of our great country, but more importantly, I am reminded of who?
Jesus.
Our Savior, Jesus Christ, right? So this holiday, we're going to remember the people. Like, there's some people here that went and fought for our freedoms. Lloyd and Rudy, and I know there's some other veterans out there that went and...
Freeman.
Yeah. Freeman, I'm trying to think of your son's name.
Vincent.
Vincent's over there right now. He's here now in the Army fighting for us. So, you know, he's doing his part. And I know there's probably some more that I forgot. Oh, I know Mr. Curtis over here. But you know what I'm saying? They went under this, and this stands for freedom. So we have to say prayers for them too, right? Okay, let's say our prayer. And there's no children's church today, but we have to get food ready. Let's say our prayer, Charlie, okay? Dear God, we thank you for giving us freedom, for dying for our sins, and giving the men and women the courage to fight for us as you fight for us every day. We love you and we honor you on this 4th of July and all year round. Amen. All right.